I'm just at the present moment we're rehearsing for a show that we're going to be in, which is the Sunshine Pavilion Festival, which is on the 30th of August. So I came up to start doing rehearsals. In the studios, I've been here and worked in studios up here before. Not ones that like I'm like, oh, I remember there and I remember there. But I just like the vibe coming outside of London. It's different, and you know, people are mixing music and coming up with different kind of vibes, and it's interesting. So it's always good to come outside of London. It was good in a sense to be able to stop and just check where you've been and where you're going with your life and with your music. And I put out an album through my label and through my own distribution on my own site, juniorgiscombe.co.uk. You can go up there and you can go and get the new album. It's called Everything Set. At the same time, I did writing with a band called AP Connection in France, and their records just come out, and we ended up at number 2 in the British charts. So that went well, and I'm now involved in another project called The Rediscovery, which is an album basically of 80s artists doing songs that they love. So you've got people like Kim Mazelle on there, Kiki D's on there, Lee John's on there, myself, I'm on there. It's brilliant. It's just a completely different kind of project, and I like to be involved in music from different angles as well, not just to, this is what he does, you know. So it was difficult because you couldn't play live, and that's the part that we all love, and that was difficult, but being able to continue to create kept the juices flowing. Get over it, step on. Do it. Sore throat time. It is, it's sore throat time. You're so pleased to get back, and you're singing and you're missing notes, but you know it'll come back because you haven't been singing and you haven't been doing it at the rate that you normally do. I can't wait. It's been hell from that respect of not being able to truly just be with guys and create music and just express and love that. So coming back to it has been fantastic. Just, I want more. It's just that you want more, I want more, I want more. You know, you just want to keep playing live and get back to what you do, so it becomes that instinctive thing that we all do, that you know, people don't get, but we do, you know what I'm saying? And you need, I think we all do, we need to get back to it so that we can get rid of all the cobwebs. I think so. I think the band's ready. We've been rehearsing for a little while. I'm just ecstatic, really, about getting back on stage and being able to see people's faces again, have them standing up and dancing again, have them singing along with you again. All of those things you miss, they're part and parcel of why you do it. It's like giving back. I'm going to bring a lot of energy. I'm going to bring a lot of energy, a lot of fun, a lot of inclusion. As you do when you do festivals, you want to bring everybody in on what you're doing. So I think we've got the right songs for it, and I think it's going to be fun. And that's a lot of what I'm about, is to, I want to be up there and I want to be having fun and I want to share that fun with you. So it's a, you know, you give, I give thing. I scratch your back, you scratch mine. And I just love to entertain. So looking forward to it. I think both. I think they'll get the classics. Mama used to say Too Late. Maybe Eloise and songs like that that was successful. Then came you. And then they'll get some of the stuff from the new album, which is a reggae album. So it's doing a lot of the songs that were successful in reggae. So you're going to get both parts of Junior when you come. So it's going to be interesting. think it's great. You've got Victor Romero, you've got Janet Kay, Omar, myself. I mean, I think when you come, you are coming to have a good time. You're coming to sing along. You're coming to have the family and watch the kids run around, and God willing that it's a nice sunny day. And that's what you're after. You're after that whole communal, let's get together, people. It's about time. And let's kind of hang and say hi to one another. We've been away from one another for a long time now. You know, as much as people will say they're not sure about it opening up, they're not this and they're not that, I totally get it. But I think we need one another. And I think things like this and festivals like this will show that. You know, we're just intrinsic, we need one another. And I think that we need to do some more things like this.
Emma used to say, take your time, young man.
I think music across the board in any shape, form or fashion is beautiful. I remember Peter Tosh once said that in my God's garden, he has many weeds. And he's not kicking them to one side. So I just look at it like that, you know. We have many, many, many brilliant, brilliant artists and stars here, you know. And I think on the day, people will get such a rounded show. It'll be an event that people, I think, will leave and will talk about for years to come. I love that. You've got to love that. You've got to, if you're in music, then you've got to love the fact of the new coming in and the kids wanting to express in a different way. But a lot of the time you listen to where they're coming from and it's like, it's what they heard from before, you know what I'm saying? And it's seeped into what they're doing and they don't even get that yet. And that's the beauty of that, if you get what I'm saying. It's a bit like when Jungle first came around and it was like 100 and odd beats per minute and everybody was going crazy on Jungle, you know, big, broad and heavy and all this stuff. It was brilliant. And then they realized that they needed to understand how to craft songs, because the beat was great, but if you had a song, right? So they started to write songs within it. And as we all know, Wicked was the big one that really took off, General Lee, right? So people are always bringing new music, grime, all of this brand new. We all express ourselves in different ways. It's not that we should be expressing ourselves in a way that should be congruent to how people see it. I think that the kids are just doing what they're doing and growing, and I love it. And I love it. And I think when they're on stage, I love to watch them because, again, they bring in something different, a different kind of energy. And it's lovely. I think she's cool, man. I think she's really cool. I've never seen her live. I've seen, if it's correct, I've seen her on YouTube, but I've never seen her live. So to be able to get a minute to see her live, that should be good. She's good.
That's where you're going to leave it.
I'm leaving it there. She's good. Wow. I think I'm in peace and contentment mode, right? I still have my activist tendencies there still, and that won't go. And I think that growth has made me a bit more structured in my life in terms of how I see it and what I like within it. It's strange. It's like, you know, you're looking at 40-year career in music and you think, where's it gone? One, what a wonderful journey. Two, and what wonderful, wonderful people I've had the pleasure to meet along the way, like yourself. But I mean it. It's like you are so fortunate to be able to travel the world. If you have, Mummy used to say, was a part of a success, but then I did a record called Do You Really Want My Love, which was in Beverly Hills Cop, and that album did over 160 million copies worldwide, and so your mind is in a completely different place. You've been very, very fortunate with the success that you've had. So with everything that you're doing, you're looking to give back on every level. So it's, if you do a video, which I have, for Step Off, and it's about the violence of young women fighting one another and the gang culture, and it was trying to do something again, you're trying to give back all the time because you've been so fortunate to have been given so much. And you can, in your own way, you can help, you can foster, nurture mindsets to move forward. That's a good thing, I think.
I feel no what a woman life worth. Nobody drip, nobody
go. I don't know, because I'm coming from an era whereby when I was buying American music, a lot of it was telling us about what was going on down in Tuskegee. A lot of it was telling us what was going on with AIDS and people being given AIDS. And so the writers of that time, Curtis Mayfield was doing a lot about Vietnam. Bob Marley was coming around and was doing a lot about what was going on within Jamaica, that was going on around the world, right? So I come from an era whereby what people were writing about was what was true to form what was happening. Today, maybe there's a bit more fiction to it. You know, the I Need to Kill You kind of records and all that kind of, you know, it's kind of like, it's not really, you're not really getting across any education to the market, to your audience. You're not telling them nothing. You're not showing them something to uplift them, to bring them forward, for them to challenge. That was my era. This era, I don't see as much of that. I think a lot of people tend to want to run along with the status quo and don't truly want to challenge it. And if they do, because of algorithms and everything else, they can be shut down a lot quicker. So I can understand it from that perspective too, that you don't want to jump in because of the fact of that. You want to keep your success bubble going. I get that too. But I think if we don't have people who stand up, young people who stand up and say the things that they're seeing on the street, not just the violence, but the good, right, enlightenment, right, you know, your audience will gravitate to those things, and I think we need more of that for the young. Future plans, I'm back in the studio, I'm going to make another album. Next year I'm out on tour with Rolls Royce, so we'll be doing about 20 dates around the country, because it's next year is 40 years of Mummy Used to Say. So I wanted to commend that by doing dates. And so we're starting there, and then I'm over in America, which is wonderful, and that'd be good fun as always, right? And just start playing live again, God willing, if everything goes correctly. Then yes, back into Europe and hopefully doing dates in France and Germany. But you know, we're not really in a time whereby you can say that's definitely going to happen and that's definitely going to happen. You know, I think it's more about a time of let's take it 4 weeks at a time. Yeah, you do. You want to go, you know, when you've been fortunate enough to be able to travel and been able to see places, and you are so uplifted by understanding that people are people anywhere and everywhere in the world, and it's fantastic to understand that and gravitate to that kind of thing. So yeah, I am content. I don't feel the when you were signed to a record company and stuff like this, there was a different kind of energy that used to go on and a different kind of drive. Now you're doing your own thing and you're driving your own car. You're driving it at your own pace, right? So what's in the future? Yeah, a new album. What's in the future? Looking to play live. What's in the future? I want to go back home to Jamaica. What's in the future? Do you get what I'm saying? I can, I am at peace. I have a wonderful family. The kids are great. I get grandsons and granddaughters, and they're fantastic too. So I just feel completely blessed. What am I worried about? It's a bit, I'll show you something. Your musical heritage is exactly the same as what was going on with us. It has to shine. You have to get your artists, your own artists. You've got to put them up there, right, with your clicks and your whatchamacallit. No, seriously, to show the cultural side of the music that's coming out of Birmingham, which is really mixed. It's a mixture. It can be banger, it can be hardcore ragga underneath it with a different kind of slant with the beat and how the kids rap on top and what they're seeing. So yeah, why not? Do you get what I'm trying to say? Music's music, you know, man. And right, if you don't acknowledge all kinds of music, I remember, who was it? I think it's one of them guys in Oasis turned around and said he didn't like black music, you know, when they were happening. And, you know, trying to make a flippant comment like that when the music that you're making is completely from there. So you know what I'm saying? You're kind of like, oh, please. But it was good for sales, or it was good for that magazine or whatever else, right? But the real is the real. And Asian music overall, right? Overall, just like, look at it now, African music, right? Look at that whole swing on African music, and everybody loves African music. Everybody can get down with the sway and how the guitars work against the sway. So good music's always going to be good, you know. Doesn't matter about the color of its skin, right? Because when I was a kid, everything was pressed black, right? So, and I never saw nobody turn around and said, I'm not going to buy that because it's a black vinyl. You get what I'm saying? So it's all rubbish in that regard, right? You know, good music is good music, man. I don't care where it comes from. It's crazy. A Change Is Gonna Come by Sam Cooke has been, I think, one of my most important records in my life, I think. When it came along, the time it came along, the message that it had, I was into just about getting like black icons and stuff like this, you know, Muhammad Ali, you know, who's a boxer, and various people who were inventors that I was learning about and stuff. And that song really, still to this day. And then my father used to love jazz, and Take Five was another song that stood out big time as well. You know, I remember him going around the house and he'd just be singing that thing, and he would the smile, and that, it was just a joy for him just to sing along with that, and I loved that. I think those two, and then I'd say Marvin Gaye's What's Going On became, I think, one of the most important records in terms of an album and what you're saying through your project. I think that was the most important thing that musically, what's going on. But I know, change gonna come. It's an uplifting song, yeah. if you take it from forget, because I think because of the chordal movements and because of the strings and because of the mood that it creates, it can make you sad. But for me, I just looked at that song as being uplifting and positive and seeing something for what it is and not what you think you'd like to see it as. And that maybe is why it's never stopped. It's always been an influencer for me. Always.
Timeless.
Yeah. I think one, people need to get out. I think two, people need to smile. I think three, a lot of people need to dance. I think four, right, we all need a hug, right? And I don't mean that in the sense of hugging every struggling person that you see. But I think we need a hug. We need to let our fellow people, our fellow human beings, know that we love them and that we care, and that we're going through a situation right now that if we stick together and we continue not to look at one another in a derogatory manner because of the way that things are being played out, and just remember to love one another and not allow tomfoolery to manipulate the situation in your mind where you're not talking to your brother or your sister because they have a different viewpoint. Watch out.